Good evening everyone. Today we are going to start with Darlington pair configuration. As you can see, the diagram is not the usual on which we regularly see into our classes. The diagram is a little bit twisty, I would say. There are two transistors, NPN transistor, being connected in a cascade connection. The emitter of the first transistor is given as an input to the second transistor. The Initially, we used to have RE over here, but today for the first time, we are using a current source over here. If needed, we might discuss that in the future courses. The diagram itself simple. The diagram is very simple. In fact, we have a common RC connection over here. If I look this as a system or a network, then over here I am having an RI, which is nothing but the input resistance of the system or the network, and here is the output resistance of the system or the network. Ab tak shayad se ye mere bachcho ko sabko pata hoga. Now for the very first time today we are seeing RID, which is nothing but the input resistance of the Darlington configuration. Name Darlington, naam mein hi darling hai, so it has to be some way, you know, very much beautiful about it. So let's see what it comprises of and what is actually what it makes it so beautiful to study. Yes, the connection which are given is plus V over here and minus V over here. You can also consider this as plus VCC and this one is minus VEE. The current source which is connected over here is bypassed over here, which eases our trip for AC analysis. Now, this diagram is being, in an AC analysis over here. So now, first of all, if this is Q1, then this is stage 1. And if this is Q2, then this stage is Q2. Now we'll go very smoothly and very simply. Now, if I'm standing over here, if I keep my pen point over here, and if I ask myself those three questions for AC analysis, the first question being, is emitter connected to ground for AC? Is RE bypassed for this point? But of course, and is fine, we'll come with two points only. I don't remember the third point exactly. So yes, standing over here, if you ask those two questions, that is emitter bypassed or is RE connected to ground, at this point the answer is no. So yes, you'll have to draw 1, 2, 3, and 4 lines. Yes, so this one will be my R pi 1. If this is R pi 1, I can name this as beta 1 IB 1, and since this is the first stage, I would write over here as B1, over here as C1, and over here as E1. Now, if you come back to the original circuit diagram, the emitter of the first transistor is given as an input to the second transistor, is given as a base to the second transistor. So yes, this E1, I'm just going to extend it, and this becomes my input over here. Since this is second stage, every naming over here would have a prefix. Jo piche wala naam hota hai, wo 2 ho jayega. For example, here it will be B2, here it will be C2, and here it will be E2. Now, standing at this point, if you ask yourself those two questions, I don't remember the third one, sorry. If you ask yourself that is emitter bypassed for AC, the answer would be yes, because you have a bypass capacitor. So there was no need to draw this ground line as a separate one, but in order to have a simple, easiness of mind, मैंने ये एक extra line draw कर दी है यहाँ पे. Now, if this is R pi 1, this is R pi 2. If this is beta 1, this is beta. This is beta 1 IB 1. This is beta 2 IB 2. Yes. If there is a connection over here, if there is E2 over here, an output current will also be present over here, named as IE. Since this is E2, this will be IE2. Similarly, over here, if I am having something over here, if this is E1 over here, this will be named as IE1. IE is generally given to us as 1 plus beta into IB, the equation. For example, if I am having, how did I get to that equation is, IE is nothing but IC plus IB, which is nothing but IB into beta plus IB. If I take this beta common, I am left out with 1 plus beta. Hence, the equation for IE1 becomes 1 plus beta 1 into IB1. Now, since this is IE1, this IE1 is acting as an input to the second transistor. This IE1 is also being named as IB2. Since this IE1 over here, IE1, is connected to the base of the second transistor, it also becomes IB2. Now, done over here. We can have an input resistor. Where is my scale? Sorry, I'm using a scale for the very first time. Now, there will be an input resistor. Let's complete the diagram first. I will be having a resistance 1, 2, 3 and done. This will be my RB, and at the input, I'll be having a simple VI. The diagram is a little bit big. This one is VI over here. Now, if you look carefully, since RB ke left hand side pe RI hai, hence over here also I'll be drawing something over here, which is nothing but RI, and RB ke right hand side mein you have RID, hence over here you will be having RID. RID, let me repeat, it is nothing but the input resistance of the Darlington pair seen standing at this point, standing from this point over here. Now, IE2, but of course it will be as good as this one, it will be given as 1 plus beta 2 IB2. Again, I'll complete the diagram over here. I'll be having an RC over here. This one is given as RC. Now, in the diagram, do we have RL? No. So, if there is only RC, if there is only RC, the output current, that is nothing but the IO, will flow through RC in an opposite direction. Hence, negative sign with VO. That will come to a later stage. First of all, let's write all the namings. If I'm having RC, the output resistance over here will be nothing but RO. We won't be having RO dash or ZO dash, something of that sort. So it's a little bit easier for us to draw the diagram. Now, let's see if anything else is remaining over here. B1, C1, E1. Okay, so here we will be having a current named as IB1. And let's see, this one will be beta 2, IB2. The current IO is done, I guess. Then I guess let's start with the analysis, as simple as it could be. Now, what you need to do is you need to first find out RID. In order to find out RID, consider yourself, or for example, suppose maine mere majnu bhai ko yahan pe khada kar diya, then he will be looking into a system which is a little bit complex, because this time yahan pe use ghus method do jagah se lana hai. He will be starting his journey from this point. He'll go up till this point. He'll see that there is a ground connection over here, and hence he'll come back from E2 to B1. Now, very simply, very smoothly, we'll be transferring the resistance RPi2 from B2 to E1. Let me repeat, when I start my journey from this point, by using the Gauss method, main yahan se meri journey start karta hun, I come to this point E2, I see that yahan pe iske baad is nothing but a ground connection. If you see carefully, it is connected to the ground. Hence, I take a U-turn from this point, and from this point I start my journey back. When I start my journey back, I have to pick up all the resistances which are on the path. Hence, the first resistance that I come in a connection with is RPi2. I have to transfer the resistance RPi2 from base to the emitter. While transferring the resistance from base to emitter, if you remember carefully, we used to multiply that thing by 1 plus beta and add it in series with RPi1. Consider this terminal as your RE. If you carefully remember, then over there we used to convert this part. We used to transfer RE from your lower part to the upper part. Hence, from here, if we transfer from B2 to E1 and finally to B1, the writing part would be something like this. Transferring RPi2 from B2, which is nothing but E1. If you look carefully over here, B2 is nothing but connection to E1 in a short circuit. From B2 or from an emitter to B1 and connecting it in series, and connecting in series with RPi1, we get, which is nothing but RID, which is nothing but, if I'm standing over here, if my Amod jo chai pita hai free mein, if my Amod is standing over here and if he's looking into the network, he's seeing a resistance in series with RPi1. So the resultant will be 1 plus beta 1 into RPi2 plus RPi1. Now, which is approximately equal to, let me say, beta, the range of which is nothing from 200, is varying from 20 to 400. So plus 1 is not making that much of a difference. Hence, I approximate it to beta R r pi 2 plus r pi 1. I name this as equation number 1, which will be used at a later stage. Now let's see what we have further. Now if you remember, for AC parameter, the r pi resistance or the r pi 1 is given as thermal voltage Vt upon Ib1. But we have Ib2 over here. Ib2 is nothing but a direct connection from over here. Ib2 is nothing but 1 plus beta 1 into Ib1, which can be approximated equal to beta 1 Ib1. Now if I use this, if I want to substitute the value of Ib1 from here, the value would be r pi 1, which is equals to Vt upon, it will be simply, if I take beta 1 over here, it will be Ib2 by beta 1, so it will be nothing but Ib2 by, or in another word, I would multiply that thing by beta 1. We get a box over here, simple sa, chotu sa. But, can I say, r pi 2 is nothing but Vt upon Ib2. Haila, sir, ye to kamal ho gaya. Sir, we can have simply as r pi 1, which is approximately equals to beta 1 directly carried forward, and instead of this, I'll write down simply r pi 2. I hope this much is clear. I'll use my daughter's crayon to highlight. It's very much efficient, I would see now. Yes. Now, substituting this equation 2 over here, I would have, in this equation, the equation which is over here, I would have Rid, which is given by beta 1 r pi 2 plus beta 1 r pi 2. Instead of r1, I am substituting the value as beta 1 r pi 2, so it is nothing but twice beta 1 r pi 2. Now I would expect aap log ye diagram ek bar apne book mein banaiye, because if once I turn out the page, you won't be able to see this diagram. So over here, I would expect you pause the diagram, you pause the video, sorry, and you draw this and this diagram for easy reference, just for the upcoming section. So now, if therefore, can I have Rid, which is nothing but twice of beta 1 into r pi. Again, I'll just put a box over here. If you consider beta, generally the range of beta is from 20 to 400, as the Boylestad Baba has said, and r pi 2 is generally given in kilo. So kilo into somewhat in 100 might give you a result which is much greater in kilo. So can I say this value, which is very high, if the value is very high. Now, what was RID first of all? RID was nothing but the input resistance of the Darlington pair configuration. Ab mujhe ek baat bataiye. Suppose Jagdish ke ghar pe ladki wale dekhne aate. Now, first of all, would he expect the guest to come at his place given the circumstances of COVID-19? No, but of course not. He would expect that the input resistance of his house should be as high as it could be, wherein the output resistance, agar ghar pe aa gaye mehman free ka chai samosa khane ya Jagdish ke haath ka kanda pohe khane, for example, I would say. So would you expect that Jagdish should treat them very well and, you know, make them sit? No, he would expect ke bhai wo unhe fatafat ravana kare. So in another words, I would expect that the input resistance should be as high as it could be and the output resistance should be as low as it could be. Now, if I look generally, which the number I'm looking over here is very, very high. Since the input resistance of Darlington pair is very high, this helps us in reducing the loading effect. Now, loading effect, we'll talk of it some another day. I would now expect that all of you might have drawn the diagram, so that we can move on to the second part, which is nothing but the current gain of Darlington pair. Again, the diagram is way much beautiful and you will love it. So yes, let's start with the second part. I expect aapne abhi tak ye aur ye dono diagram draw karke rakha ho. If not, please do pause the diagram, please do pause the video and draw it once in your book. Now let's move on to page number 2. The first thing that I'll do is I'll write down current. Wait, I'll just take this a little bit down. Sorry for the shabby handwriting. Current gain of Darlington pair. Now, why do we use this thing very much? Why? What is so beautiful about it? We'll come to know in just some 5-10 minutes. Just be patient with me. Now, if you look carefully into the diagram which you have drawn, can you tell me the output current which you have? It will be nothing but IO, and the input current that you have for your Darlington pair. Can I say it is nothing but IB1? Now, output current upon input current, output upon input, can I say it is nothing but a gain? Now, if it is gain, which kind of gain? Is it a voltage gain, current gain, or some another gain? Since it is current upon current, it is nothing but current gain. Sir, AI to ab tak bahut dekha, sir, bahut dekh liye. But sir, what is so special about this? Let us have it named as AID. Now, can I, looking into the diagram which you have done on this side of your book, the AC analysis, can I have the output current IO as nothing but IC1 plus IC2? Now, how did I come to this point is, I'll just come back to this part. Now, the current which is coming from here and the current which is coming from here, it is, they both are getting added at some point and they are getting back into the circuit. So this one is IC1, this one is IC2. They both combine and become IO. I'll just remove this sheet once again. Now, it is nothing but IO. The output current is given as IC1 plus IC2, which is equals to, can I write this as IC1 as beta1 IB1 plus beta2 IB2. I have just written IC in the format of beta IB. Now, beta1 IB1 plus beta2 IB2. Now, for example, since if I'm using two transistors, I would generally take transistors which have beta value somewhat nearby. I wouldn't expect ki bhai unka value mein zyada differentiation ho. If that is the case, can I consider, if I'm considering that thing, let's come back to that point later. First of all, let us have beta1 IB1 plus beta2 IB2. Now, this IB2, if I look back into the diagram, please do look into the diagram over here. This IB2 was nothing but 1 plus beta1 IB1. Hence, can I write this thing as beta1 IB1 plus beta2 1 plus beta1 into, sir, aa gaya sir mere ko. Sir, this is nothing but IB1. Now, sir, if I generally look into the diagram, it is nothing but which can be approximately equal to beta1 IB1 plus, can I have 1 plus beta1? If the range of beta is from 20 to 400, I would generally expect ki bhai main 1 add karu ya na karu, wo bahut baad ki baat hai, mujhe baad mein difference pata chalta hai uska. So generally I'll take this as simply beta1, I'll neglect this 1 over here. It's as simple as you're having a gain as 400 and this one is nothing but 401. So I'll just take the gain to be as 400 for now. So can I have this reduced to beta1 into this term over here, which is nothing but beta2 into IV1. Sir, mujhe bhavishya dikh raha hai. Sir, yahan se na sir. Sir, main yahan pe na IB1 beta1 common le lunga. And sir, in the bracket, I'll be left out with 1 plus beta2. Now, again, as I said, I'll write it down over here. Sir, 400 likhu ya 401 likhu, sir, multiply kar raha hu na sir, itna kuch farak nahi padega. So now, as for now, let us approximate it that to IB1 into beta1 into beta2. Sir, kuch to dikh raha hai, sir, therefore kar do, sir, ho gaya, sir. Sir, this is nothing but the current gain. Kaise re baba, kaise, let's see, smoothly re beta. Current gain, which is nothing but आउटपुट करंट आयो. सर ये जो आई बी था ना सर, सर आपने ये इसके नीचे ले लिया सर, आयो अपॉन आई बी वन will be given as beta 1 into beta 2. सर इसे तो हमें मजा आ गया सर, अगर एक का भी वैल्यू अगर समझो मिनिमम 100 है, 100 सर, और इसका 200 है, व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू? 20,000. कंसिडर गिविंग योर सॉकेट 20 mV एज एन इनपुट एंड मल्टीप्लाइंग दैट थिंग बाय 20,000 एज एन आउटपुट. डोंट यू थिंक इट्स सिंपली अमेजिंग? सर द करंट गेन ऑफ डार्लिंगटन पेन इज सो हाई, सर इतना ज़्यादा है ना, विच इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल विद सिंगल ट्रांजिस्टर, एज वी हैड सीन इन सिंगल स्टेज मल्टी स्टेज. सर इट वॉज नॉट एट ऑल पॉसिबल ड्यू टू दिस हाई करंट गेन, ड्यू टू दिस मैन, ये जोड़ी के वजह से, दिस बंटी बबली के वजह से, द करंट गेन ऑफ डार्लिंगटन पेयर इज नोन एज सुपर बीटा ट्रांजिस्टर. दिस वन इज नोन एज सुपर बीटा ट्रांजिस्टर. सर यहाँ तो सर एकदम मजा आ भी गई सर एकदम सर फंटास्टिक छे सर, यहाँ बीटा वन छे, यहाँ बीटा टू छे. एज फॉर नाउ लेट मी स्टॉप इट ओवर हियर द टुडेज लेक्चर. कम बैक टू मी इफ यू हैव सम डाउट्स, लेट मी नो हाउ वाज द लेक्चर एंड व्हाट आर द इम्प्रूवमेंट दैट आई कैन डू, एंड विल मीट टुमारो एज यूजुअल. यप, थैंक यू एवरीवन, थैंक यू.